everybody, Basilray from BCF, YouTube, Vape and Review, New Vapor Forum, all over the place. And I've got a nice quick review I wanted to put out today. I just got this in the mail over the weekend from Bruce over at Clouds of Vapor. Many thanks to you, my friend. This is a Cisco low resistance 510 atomizer. So this will partner up nicely with the Cisco low resistance 306 atomizer that I traditionally rock on my WetBox. So I got it. The first thing I did was meter it out, and this one, grab it here, metered out at 1.4 ohms of resistance right on the nose. Now I know these are said to be 1.5, and that's what's actually even marked right here on the atomizer, 1.5. The couple that I did meter out both read 1.4. I just tested two out of the five that I got. Three of them went to a buddy. We kind of split the order a bit. Initial impressions, I really like this. This actually I do prefer to the Cisco low resistance 306 atomizer. It doesn't put out quite as much vapor, it seems. So it's real comparable to the 306, but a little bit lacking there. Doesn't have quite as much throat hit, but the flavor does come out, and it is much nicer, I think, on the Cisco low resistance 510 than it is on the 306 here. So today, just for the sake of comparison, I am rocking Backwoods Brew's RY4 in my silver bullet here, 3.7 volts low resistance, and also have it in my wet box with a Cisco 306 low resistance atomizer here. So I'll show you a quick vapor production here, and we'll talk about the warmth and some of that stuff. So first we'll give it the 510. And you can see it vapes great here. Let's take a look at the Cisco 306. So it's neck and neck. I think that the 306 maybe puts out just a touch more vapor, and it is a touch warmer. Part of that is because you're so much closer to the actual coil of the atomizer when you're inhaling. You're a little bit farther away here. Not that that should make a ton of temperature difference, but it's a slight bit warmer on the 306 at 3.7 volts than it is on the 510. The throat hit is definitely greater with the 306, but you're sacrificing some flavor, I feel like, on the 306 compared to this 510. This 510 is going to quickly replace the Cisco low resistance 306 as being my favorite atomizer. So this has also surpassed East Mall's low resistance 510 as my favorite low resistance atomizer. Bang for your buck, if this holds up, and I just got this over the weekend, but if this holds up nearly as well as the 306 that I've been using for pretty much over a month now, then I think we're in business here, folks. So one more shot of the vapor here on the 510. And I'm not sure if the camera is going to pick it up. One thing that I've noticed, the Cisco 306 is kind of noisy. You can really hear it burning and crackling when it heats up. And you hear that here too, more so than on other low resistance atomizers that I've used. Another quick note, when you look at some low resistance atomizers, when you're heating up and doing a dry burn, you look right in here at the coil. You'll notice the coil isn't always wrapped evenly, and there's a lot of spacing between the wraps of the coil. These Cisco low resistance atomizers, both the 306 and the 510, you can see the coil is wrapped up real tight and nice and neat, almost into it almost looks like a solid piece of wire when it heats up. They're real close together. They provide a real nice warm vapor. Overall, you're not going to go wrong with the Cisco 306 or the Cisco 510 low resistance atomizers, and it's going to really just come down to vapor's preference. Mine is going to be the 510 because I get optimal flavor there compared to the 306. Now again, these are supposed to be 1.5 ohm resistance atomizers. Both my 306s and my 510s have metered out at 1.4. So it could be my cheap meter throwing it off by that, you know, tenth of an ohm, but I'm leaning towards both of these being 1.4, and I think that's part of the reason these are so juice hungry. The 510 is going to use a touch more juice than your standard low resistance atomizer, but it doesn't tear through the juice as fast as the 306. So for juice consumption and flavor, I'm going to stick with the Cisco Low Resistance 510. I'm going to keep rocking this 306 on my wet box and just see how long it lasts. I'm really curious. This thing just chugs along, and it's great. And I'm really hard on my atomizers. I dry burn them, you know, at least every other day, give them a real good solid dry burn. And I've been excessively abusive on these Cisco Low Resistance atomizers, just trying to get one to pop, and I have not been able to do it. These things are great. They really take a beating. So if you haven't picked one up, I suggest you head over to a place like Clouds of Vapor. Grab yourself a Cisco Low Resistance 510. Bruce will take care of you there. He took care of me. He got it out super fast. I ordered on, I want to say, Wednesday, and it showed up at my door on Saturday. And I ordered like late in the day on Wednesday. So super fast shipping from Bruce, wherever he's at, all the way to here to South Minneapolis, where I'm at. So kudos to Bruce once again. I'll be back someday. If these atomizers ever blow out, I will be back someday to order more, but we will see how it goes. So that's just kind of an initial impression here. I've got to give, overall, the hats off to the Cisco Low Resistance 510 when I compare it to the 306, but they're both really great atomizers, and you're not going to go wrong either way. So, until I catch you guys again, a couple of juice reviews, I plan on getting out here in a week. And I will see you guys around.
About it.